And a very, very happy birthday if today is your birthday. On Thursday, January 25th, my son celebrates his 9th birthday this weekend. So a big happy birthday shout out to my son, Charlie. If today is your birthday, here's some celebrities that you share your birthday with. Alicia Keys turns 43 today. Rapper Lil Mosey turns 22. And wrestler Michelle McCool turns 44. Also, Vladimir Zelensky, the president, world leader, is 46 today. So happy birthday to all of them. And of course, happy birthday to all of you guys out there who are celebrating a birthday today. I hope everybody has a great day. We got a good show for you lined up. We got a bunch of stuff to talk about. So let's get right into it. I'm going to talk about my NFC AFC predictions for this weekend. I did go 4-0 yesterday or last week on my picks for the divisional series and 8-2 total for the playoffs. So not too bad so far, 80%. Let's see. This weekend we got the Chiefs and the Ravens. I got the Ravens. Baltimore is going to take that one. Sorry, Taylor Swift, you will not be at the Super Bowl, at least not cheering on your boyfriend. You may be there as a spectator with him, but definitely not going for the championship. And then we got the 49ers and Lions. I've got the Lions winning it. People say, why would you be going for the Lions? You are a fan of the Bears. Why would you go for the Lions? I go for the Lions because, you know why? I think that they should win the championship. They have never won a Super Bowl. Why not? The Chicago Bears have won it before. Why can't the Lions win one? The Packers have gotten one. Hell, I'd even go for the Vikings if the Vikings ever made it to the Super Bowl. So the only division team that I never want to see win is the Green Bay Packers. So, yeah, I got the Ravens and I've got the Lions this weekend. So we'll see what happens there. My big prediction is for it to be, obviously, the Ravens and the Lions in the Super Bowl. Lamar Jackson versus Goff, and it's going to be a great time. I hope that this happens. Super Bowl is going to be exciting. Reba McEntire is going to be there. Post Malone's performing America the Beautiful. And then, of course, the big halftime show from Usher. So it's going to be a great show. I just hope it's two great teams playing. And I hope it's the teams that I picked that are going to win the Super Bowl this year. Lamar Jackson, he's definitely going to be, I believe, the MVP this year. And he deserves it. He's had a great career. Speaking of him, I really do believe that, in my eyes, Justin Fields will eventually be the next Lamar Jackson. I don't care what anybody says, and he's going to do it in a Bears uniform, and I would love to see that. I think everybody in Chicago, for the most part, would like to see that, except for the people who want to see Caleb Williams come into the Bears. Not going to happen. I think the Chicago Bears end up going with a trade of the number one pick, maybe moving it to number two or three, giving either the Patriots or the Washington Commanders that number one spot so they can get Caleb Williams. And then I believe that we will end up still getting Marvin Harrison Jr. And if we don't, I think we'll get wide receiver Odunze. I think we're going to get him either him or obviously Marvin Harrison Jr. You don't need both. You don't need both of them. I believe we need a slot receiver, maybe a veteran slot receiver in there. Somebody like Darnell Mooney. Maybe the Bears try to sign him back, but I don't think he's going to want to play at a number three spot. I think he's going to want either number one, which he'll never get, or number two. Everybody says, well, he was number one for the Bears. Yeah, when there was no DJ Moore. He was the only option. But notice, once he was the second option, he couldn't catch for crap. He has to be that number one guy or he doesn't care. And he's not going to get that in Chicago. It's just not going to happen here. So, yeah, if I'm Ryan Poles, I'm going with a trade of the number one spot and then taking Marvin Harrison Jr. at two or three. And then at number nine, I would definitely be going after an offensive lineman. I would definitely go after somebody offensive line because we do need a new center, which we could probably get in free agency. It's going to be a very interesting offseason. I was telling one of my coworkers, I'm like, you know, honestly, I would not. I don't know if I want to be Ryan Poles in this spot, because no matter what he does, the fans are going to be pissed. Somebody's going to be mad at him. If he keeps Fields, they're going to be mad. If he gets Caleb Williams, they're going to be mad. If he doesn't get Marvin Harrison Jr. but takes Odunze, they're going to be mad. You know, the thing is, it's hard to be a GM in the NFL or any sport because the fans always have to ruin it. I will still support the Chicago Bears, regardless, if they get Caleb Williams. I will support Caleb Williams just like I did Justin Fields. I'll laugh at him when he runs into the stands and cries on his mom's bosom, like he did against Notre Dame. But yeah, like I said, no, I will support him. I'll buy his jersey just like I did Fields, just like I did Nick Foles. I'll do it because I am a Chicago Bears fan through and through. And that's just how I am. I will always be a Chicago Bears fan, no matter what they do. This is a true fan. Ryan Poles needs to look the fans straight in the eyes and say, I can see that none of you have ever even played a snap of football in your life. You probably never played in high school. You probably didn't even play in the Pee Wee League. Because I'll be honest with you right now, there's no reason why the Chicago Bears need to listen to what the fans say. If you don't like Fields, go wherever Caleb goes. If you're a fan of Caleb and he comes here and you're a fan of Fields and you're mad about it, then go where Fields goes. It's very simple. Switch teams. Go cheer on Green Bay. Go be a fan of the 49ers. Go be a fan of anybody else. Because what we want in Chicago is true Bears fans that will support the team no matter who they get, whether we believe it was a mistake or not. And you know, we can believe it's a mistake today. But if we're hoisting up that trophy at the end of the year one year, and it's Caleb Williams or it's Justin Fields, I don't care how mad you were that they came here or stayed. The point is, you are champions of the league. And that's what's important. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter who's the quarterback. It doesn't matter who the receivers are. It doesn't matter who's the GM, the coach. People mad that Harbaugh left and went to the Los Angeles Chargers. Congratulations to my favorite college coach of all time, Jim Harbaugh. Brought my Michigan Wolverines the national championship this year. Went out on top and now going back to the NFL. Maybe one day he'll win a Super Bowl. Would I have loved him in Chicago? Sure. Am I mad he's not here? No. Am I mad at Eberflus being here? Not even a little bit. Eberflus changed that defense around. He got a pass rusher, and he made that defense a top five defense for the last half of the season. And I believe because of that, he deserves to be here in Chicago. Now we have an offensive coordinator who hopefully is better. Hopefully he's going to be better than Getsy. The jury's still going to be out until the season starts. But even if he struggles his first year, it's his first year. I don't understand why in the city everything has to be now or never. People were mad that it was Shane Waldron. Why? Do you even know about him? Or do you just go based on what Seattle Seahawks fans say about him? Because those same Seahawks fans, I can guarantee, were praising him while he was there. Now he left, and now they're mad. It's amazing to me. Shane Waldron was a great pick. He was a great pickup. He's going to be a good offensive coordinator. He likes to run some screen passes, but does he like to do 20 to 30 a game? That's the difference. All NFL coaches do a screen pass here and there. All of them do it. They all do screen passes. It's how many a game you do and how predictable you make them. Is Shane Waldron going to run the same play three times in a row after it was unsuccessful the first and second time? Most likely not. I heard Oakland wants to get Las Vegas wants to get Getsy. Just remember, make your players learn the screen pass because they're going to probably be using a lot of that. And you know what? Screen passes do work if you have the blockers to use it. Apparently the Bears didn't have that on offense, which we know. Their offensive line was crap. They don't have blocking. They need to work on that. Maybe Shane Waldron will help them with that. I'm excited for the Bears. I'm excited for what they're doing. All right, so we talked about the Bears' new coordinator. We talked about my predictions. Go Lions, go Ravens. I want to see a good Super Bowl this year. I don't believe the Chiefs and Niners are going to do that. don't want to see Mahomes get another title right now. Not ready for that again. I don't believe the team's even good enough to do it this year. So I'd rather see the Ravens get in. I think the Ravens are ready for a title. And I can tell you now, Detroit's been long ready for a title. So I'm really hoping that the Lions win it. And I'm going to say it now, and I'll say it, you know, when we talk about the Super Bowl the week. I'm not going to talk about the Super Bowl much next week. We'll talk about it the week after, because that's when the Super Bowl will be. It won't be the week after next week. It'll be the week after that. So we'll talk about it more towards Super Bowl. But I think everybody, from what I just said, knows who I'm going to go for in the Super Bowl this year and who I'm going to cheer on. And even though they probably will be big underdogs, no matter who they face in there, whether it would be Kansas City or the Ravens, Lions are going to be a very big long shot to win it against either one of them, but I'll take that risk. Because you know what? The Lions did something that they haven't done in over 32 years. They won their first playoff game, and then what did they do? They won another one. Oh, if you guys want to be entertained, definitely go listen to the new Justin Timberlake song. It just dropped today. It's amazing. You can hear it on iHeartRadio, Spotify, pretty much anywhere that you get music. I can't play it long on the show, but I'm going to do a quick little thing of it. Here's the intro, the beginning. Let me get there. Hang on, that's not it. Here we go. Okay, that's all I can do because I don't want to get in trouble. But that's new Justin Timberlake song. Definitely check it out. It's called Selfish. He released it today, so I'm guessing there's a new album on the way from Justin Timberlake. We'll see. But definitely check that out. As all the wrestling fans know, this weekend is the Royal Rumble, Saturday, January 27th at 7 p.m. Central Time. Make sure you check it out on Peacock. Here's a few of the matches and what I think is going to happen. We got Logan Paul and Kevin Owens. I think Logan Paul gets the win in that one. I think he's going to carry that U.S. title into WrestleMania, and he'll have a big match at Mania for it. Maybe four or five guys in it. We'll see what happens. So we got that match. There's really not that many matches right now. The undisputed WWE Universal Championship is online. Roman Reigns, the champion, will take on Randy Orton, LA Knight, and AJ Styles. This match between Roman, Randy, LA Knight, and AJ Styles is going to be off the chain. I really have a strong hope, even though I have a feeling Roman's going to win. I have a strong hope that it's going to be Randy Orton to go into WrestleMania, and I'll tell you why in a minute. But here's the women's Royal Rumble match. Here's the confirmed entrance. Now remember, there's 30 women and 30 men. Okay, so this is only a few that are going to be in it. So far confirmed, we got Bayley, Nia Jax, Becky Lynch, Bianca Belair, Maxine Dupree, and Ivy Nile. That's the only one. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 women out of 30 confirmed. Now, you obviously know that there's going to be a lot more. There's going to be a few surprise entrants in it. I believe that a few of your surprises are going to be Maryse is one of them. I heard that she was training. And the big one for me is CM Punk's wife, AJ Lee. She's been training for a while now for a possible in-ring return, and of course it's going to be in the WWE because that was her home before she left after CM Punk got fired. So, of course, with him coming back, there is a good chance that she may come back too, and I think she's going to be a surprise entrance. There's always Michelle McCool that could be in there, Tori Wilson. I don't think the Bella Twins, because of everything that happened in the past, so I'm aiming more for my surprise entrance to be either Maryse, which is almost a guarantee because I heard she was going to be in Florida with The Miz for this. And then, of course, you know, I think Michelle McCool, because she's usually in it. And then Like I said, definitely at the AJ Lee. I think AJ Lee's music hits, that place will pop like crazy, and she'll be there. My winner of the Women's Royal Rumble, obviously, it's hard to say because there's not a lot in there, but I think Bayley wins it. I think she'll end up going after Io Sky for the Women's Championship on SmackDown. I think she will not be part of the crew anymore. And yeah, so I think that she goes on to women main event WrestleMania in that aspect. Here's the men's. We have a few more men than women. Here's the confirmed entrance for the men. Damian Priest, Kofi Kingston, Akira Tozawa, Otis, Chad Gable, Gunther, Drew McIntyre, Bobby Lashley, Shinsuke Nakamura, and the two odds-on favorite to win it, CM Punk and Cody Rhodes. My final three, I'd say a final four, but I'm not sure who's going to be there yet. CM Punk, Cody Rhodes, and Gunther are for sure going to be the final three. Final four, people are going to say, I don't think so, but I think it's going to be The Rock. I think The Rock is going to be a surprise entrance in the Royal Rumble. I think he'll come out number 30. I think when number 30 hits and you hear, if you smell what The Rock is cooking, he's going to come running down. Other possible surprise entrance, John Cena is always a possibility. Any of the guys from the World Championship match with Roman Reigns could possibly be in the Rumble if the Rumbles last. To maybe try to say, well, if I couldn't win the match, I'll just jump into the Royal Rumble. But I don't think all of them will be in it. I think it'll be like one or two, maybe Randy Orton, possibly Brock Lesnar could end up being in there as a surprise entrance. LA Knight could end up being in there, even though he's in that championship match. I don't see any of them winning it, though, because they lost earlier in the night. They're not going to win it. But yeah, the final four, if I have to predict right, it's going to be CM Punk, Cody Rhodes, Gunther, and The Rock. And I believe if The Rock is in it, he's going to win it. Oh, and one more surprise entrant I think is going to be there, Hulk Hogan. When he did that the other day, and it's his 40th year since Hulkamania started, I can see them put him in there, and he'll, you know, be in there for maybe 5 minutes, and then he'll get thrown over. And you know what? I wouldn't be mad about it. If I saw Hulk Hogan come out, I really wouldn't be that mad. But yeah, so as long as he's not in the top four, I don't think I want to see that. But I would bring him out maybe halfway through, maybe number 20, you know, something like that. I think Drew McIntyre will be there towards the end too, but I don't think he's in the final four if The Rock is there. But my prediction is if The Rock is in it, he's going to win it. And he's going to headline WrestleMania with Roman Reigns for the title and for the head of the table, where he will lose. If he's not, then it will be between Cody and CM Punk at the end. And if they want to completely swerve the WWE Universe, if The Rock gets in, have him get eliminated by Punk and Cody. Or have Roman come down and interfere and pull him out. Obviously, I know, you know, so far they didn't name a lot of guys, but I know the Usos are both going to probably be in it too. Maybe Sami Zayn. Possibly Kevin Owens, even though he's going for the United States Championship. He may still be in there. Logan Paul might be still in there. You know, you could be in a match earlier in the night and still be in the Rumble. They used to do that in the 90s all the time. People would be in matches, and then later on they'd be in the Rumble match. So it could happen. But yeah, there's a lot of big name men in there. But we'll see. But I think my final, because my thing is, if Randy Orton wins the title, they have the perfect opportunity to have Cody win it and face off against Randy Orton and finish his story against a guy who was in the same crew as him. Everybody remembers Cody and Randy Orton. Everybody remembers that. What a great storyline that would be. And we all know that they have history with each other, so it would be perfect. Then you could put CM Punk as the Elimination Chamber winner. He would face off against Seth Rollins. And The Rock and Roman can still happen at WrestleMania because they could just face off for the head of the table. So right there, you just booked three matches. Easy matches right there. If not, you get CM Punk and Cody Rhodes against each other, and then have them headline next year or something. We'll see what happens. But if The Rock comes in, I really believe The Rock is going to win it. But I really believe it's going to be a very good pay-per-view this weekend. I'm excited to see. I'm sure there'll be a few matches added on, maybe tomorrow night on SmackDown. So we'll see what happens there. But I'm excited for that. And I think everybody else is too. So it's going to be a good one. Make sure everybody goes and gets Peacock. You can get a 7-day, I believe, free trial of it, usually. So, you know, you could do that. Or if not, it's only like $6. People used to spend $50 on these pay-per-views. You could spend $5 on a good one. It's going to be decent. There's always fun surprises at the Royal Rumble. Always some returns. I hear Matt Cardona could be there. I also heard that the Perfect 10 could show up now that he left AEW. So who knows who's going to be there. We're going to see, but I'm excited for it. For all you Olympic basketball fans out there, the player pool has been selected for the 41 players that have a chance to make it into the USA basketball for playing for the Dream Team. Let's see, the NBA playoffs, it says that the USA Basketball hopes to have a roster decision by early in the NBA playoffs, which begin in late April. The last five Olympic teams were finalized in June or July of the Olympic year. So here's the player pool of the guys who could possibly be in there. Bam Adebayo from the Miami Heat, Jared Allen from the Cleveland Cavaliers, Paolo Banchero from the Orlando Magic, Desmond Bane of the Memphis Grizzlies, Scotty Barnes of the Toronto Raptors, Devin Booker of the Phoenix Suns, Mikal Bridges of the Brooklyn Nets, Jaylen Brown of the Boston Celtics, Jalen Brunson of the New York Knicks, Jimmy Butler, Chicago connection from the Miami Heat, Chicago Bulls, Alex Caruso, hope he gets it, I would love to see that, Stephen Curry from the Golden State Warriors, Anthony Davis of the Los Angeles Lakers, Chicago boy, hope he gets in too again, even though he's a Packer fan, not a fan of that, but that's okay, I still love Anthony Davis, Kevin Durant of the Phoenix Suns, Anthony Edwards of the Minnesota Timberwolves, Joel Embiid of the Philadelphia 76ers, De'Aaron Fox of the Sacramento Kings, Paul George of the LA Clippers, Aaron Gordon from the Denver Nuggets, Tyrese Hempelburton of the Indiana Pacers, James Harden from the Clippers, Josh Hart from the New York Knicks, Tyler Hero of the Miami Heat, Drew Holiday from the Boston Celtics, Chet Holmgren from the Oklahoma City Thunder, Brandon Ingram of the New Orleans Pelicans, Kyrie Irving from Dallas, Jalen Jackson Jr. of Memphis, LeBron James of the Lakers, Cam Johnson from the Nets, Walker Kessler from the Utah Jazz, Kawhi Leonard of the Clippers, Damian Lillard of the Bucks, Donovan Mitchell of the Cleveland Cavaliers, Chris Paul from the Golden State Warriors, Bobby Portis of the Milwaukee Bucks, another Chicago boy or a Chicago connection, hope he gets in too, Austin Reeves from the Los Angeles Lakers, Duncan Robinson of the Miami Heat, Jason Tatum, Boston Celtics, Derek White of the Boston Celtics, and Trae Young of the Atlanta Hawks. So of all those 41 players that I just mentioned, it'll go down to like a 12-man roster. And they'll cut, you know, guys out, and then they'll go. So we'll see what happens. The head coach of the USA basketball is going to be Steve Kerr from the Golden State Warriors, so I'm pretty sure that Stephen Curry is going to get in there. Missing from there is Draymond Green. He wasn't even in consideration for it. So I think it's because of his suspension that he got into. So yeah, that's a big one there. So we'll see who gets picked for it, but I'm excited for that. I hope that they end up having a good list of guys. I hope a few of those Chicago connections like Jimmy Butler and Alex Caruso, Bobby Portis get in. That'd be cool to see. And next topic, let's move on. I saw something interesting the other day when I was looking through the internet, just looking for stories and stuff to talk about, and I saw 25 huge stars who have never hosted Saturday Night Live, and it's actually pretty funny because there's a lot of big stars that have, but these 25 have never in their careers, even at the beginning of their careers, have ever been a host of SNL. And here's some of them. And some are shocker. Some I don't think would do it anyway. Number one, Leonardo DiCaprio. He He has never hosted Saturday Night Live. Let's see. Meryl Streep has never been a host. Brad Pitt, never been a host on SNL. Will Smith, very big shocker, especially during the Fresh Prince times. Julia Roberts, never been on there. Denzel Washington has never hosted. Carol Burnett, who was funny in sketch comedies, has never been a host on it. Sandra Bullock, very shocked with that one. Ellen Pompeo from Grey's Anatomy has never been on there. Viola Davis has never hosted SNL. Tom Cruise, it's another big one, especially when Top Gun and all that came out in the 80s. Marky Mark Wahlberg has never hosted. And I believe he has never even performed. The only thing he did, he made a brief cameo on SNL confronting Andy Samberg for the comedian's extremely accurate impression of him. So he's been on there once for that, but never hosted, never performed. Harrison Ford, another one that never was on there. Angelina Jolie. Johnny Depp, even in the time when he was on 21 Jump Street, before he became huge. Zendaya. Zendaya's never been on there. Euphoria, Spider-Man, never been there. Al Pacino, never hosted. Elizabeth Moss, she's never been on there. And her husband, or actually I think he's ex-husband now, Fred Armisen, was on there. And he never got her to be on there. I'm surprised. Joaquin Phoenix, I think he'd be good on Saturday Night Live. Keanu Reeves, Bill and Ted, still never hosted. Ali Wong from the show Beef has never been on there. Florence Pugh, don't even know who she is, but she's never done it. She's apparently pretty big. She's only been a star for 5 years, so she's out of time. Whoopi Goldberg, even when she was doing movies back in the day. Chelsea Handler, she's a comedian. She'd be perfect for that show. Never hosted. Kevin Costner, not a shocker. He's kind of dry. I don't think he'd be that good. That's it. But yeah, those 25 celebrities have never hosted SNL. I'm in shock by that. It actually does shock me. But some of those people are Oscar winners, and I've noticed a lot of Oscar winners and nominees don't do SNL skits. They just don't. And speaking of SNL, and speaking of the Oscars, I do have the list of Oscar nominees. I'm not going to go over every single award because we'd be here for another hour just in that. So I'll just do the main ones. Best Picture, American Fiction, Anatomy of a Fall, Barbie, The Holdovers, Killers of the Flower Moon, Maestro, Oppenheimer, Past Lives, Poor Things, and The Zone of Interest are all up for Best Picture. Best Director, which was actually snubbed, the Barbie movie, the one that did it, Greta, whatever her name is, I don't even know her name, I never even seen the movie yet, but as many awards as it's been up for, to not, and it's up for Best Picture, but not Best Director, that's a slap in the face, and I agree. But Best Director, they've got Justine Trent for Anatomy of a Fall, Martin Scorsese for Killers of the Flower Moon, Christopher Nolan for Oppenheimer, Yorgos Lanthimos for Poor Things, and Jonathan Glazer for The Zone of Interest. Best Actor, Bradley Cooper is up for it, for Mastaro. Coleman Domingo for Rustin, Paul Giamatti for The Holdovers, Cillian Murphy for Oppenheimer, and Jeffrey Wright for American Fiction. Best Actress, here's the nominees for that. Annette Bening for Naiad, Lily Gladstone for Killers of the Flower Moon, Sandra Huller for Anatomy of a Fall, Carey Mulligan for Mastaro, never heard of that one, and Emma Stone for Poor Things. Best Supporting Actor, Sterling K. Brown for American Fiction, Robert De Niro for Killers of the Flower Moon, Robert Downey Jr. from Oppenheimer, Ryan Gosling from Barbie, and Mark Ruffalo for Poor Things. See, Ryan Gosling got in for Supporting Actor. But, watch this for Supporting Actress. Emily Blunt for Oppenheimer, Danielle Brooks for The Color Purple, American Fiera for Barbie, Jodie Foster for Naiad, and Divine Joy Randolph for The Holdovers. But when you looked at Best Actress, guess who wasn't on there? That's right, from Barbie. How did she not make it? How could you honestly say that she does not have what it takes in a movie like that that was up for Best Picture? How is it not up for Best Actress, Best Actor? They got Supporting Actor, not Best Director. Come on. I mean, everybody that saw Barbie loved it. So I just don't understand how it got snubbed for Best Actress and Best Director. And you can say because they're women, but I mean, come on. Greta Gerwig should have probably been in there for Best Director. Margot Robbie, the hot Margot Robbie, should have been in there for Best Actress. Let's see. Best Actor, we did Best Actress. Let's see. So yeah, Best Original Screenplay, Best Adapted Screenplay. Barbie's on that one. Oppenheimer's on that. They both got a lot. Best Cinematography, Oppenheimer's on that one. Barbie's on Best Production Design. Let's see. But yeah, a lot of awards. I'm not going to go over all of them because we'd be here forever. Best Costume Design, Barbie was on there, and Oppenheimer. Let's see. What about Best Song? Isn't there a Best Song for that? Best Original Song, I'm Just Ken from Barbie is on there. What I Was Made For, which is the song that Billie Eilish did, that's on there for Best Song. So yeah, a lot of Barbie, but they got snubbed for Best Director and then Best Actress. Margot Robbie has every right to be upset about that. I don't disagree with it, and as a fan of movies, it just shows why I don't like the Oscars. That to me is as bad of a snub as when Jerry Springer didn't get into In Memoriam on the Golden Globes. Like, that to me, it was just ridiculous. And this too. So, but I usually don't watch the Oscars much. I'll let everybody know who wins, you know, and everything. But, you know, we'll talk about it after the Oscars are over. I believe it's in March. But yeah, no, I'm not a fan of that. And I work on Sunday nights, and I definitely wouldn't take a Sunday night off to watch the Oscars. So we'll talk about it the Thursday after, Friday after, whichever I do a show on, and we'll talk about that. All right, we're going to do, to finish the show out today, we're going to do this every show to finish out the show. I'm going to do a top 10 list of my favorite from whatever I decide. Could be movies, could be music, could be sports teams, could be, you know, anything that's a top 10. Could be my top 10 favorite food. And I want to hear people disagree or agree with me on stuff. I'm also going to post it on my TikTok, so come and follow me there. It's in the show notes below. But I'm going to start out today with my top 10 alternative bands for alternative music. So let's get into that. All right, so band number 10 is Imagine Dragon. Number 9 of my favorites is Nine Inch Nails. Number 8 is the band Bush. Number 7, 3 Days Grace. Number 6 is Linkin Park. Number 5 is the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Number 4, Nirvana. Number 3 is the Foo Fighters. Number 2 of my favorite is Blink-182. And number 1 of my favorite alternative groups of all time is Green Day. I want to see who disagrees and agrees with it. I'm also going to put this on TikTok. So make sure that you follow me there. I'll do another top 10 next week, and then next week we'll talk about who won the AFC-NFC Championship games, who won the Royal Rumble matches, and at the Royal Rumble, and I'll have some more entertainment news for everybody. I will be back next week, so make sure that everybody has a great weekend. Make sure you follow me on all the social media sites. All you have to do is look down below at the show notes, and that's all on there. And so, yeah, I will see everybody next week. Have a great weekend. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, and...
don't die, and have a good birthday if it's your birthday.
I'll see everybody next week. Peace.